Eto naman po, kung meron pong tanim bala, meron na namang tanim tao, no? Eto, minor ito, no? Kasi we really raised this concern. Kasi ang takot namin doon sa ginagawa nilang tunnel, baka bigla magsasabi sila, oy, may nakita kaming minor person po dito. So, nakita namin yan, may video yan, minor, dinamitan ng pulis. At kumpirmado namin na sila ang nagpadala kasi nung bumalik siya, sumakay siya doon sa coaster ng PNP. Merong video po niyan.
Who are these people?
I don't know, Your Honor.
No, I'm asking General Torre.
Yes, Your Honor. Kanina ko pa gustong to disabuse the mind of Attorney Torreon. Para accurate, sir, basahin ko na lang, sir, ang proof. Relevant law. Mabagal lang aking abogado. Oh, so that we'll read it from the court. From the revised rules of court, section 10. Rules of criminal procedure, sir. Para ma-disabuse siya, sir. Actually, sir, alam ni Attorney Torreon, sir, that there's nothing illegal in using the civilians because we will confirm those are civilians that we...
So you confirm they are civilians?
Yes, sir. And we did that.
They are not policemen?
They are not policemen, sir, because
but
they are experts.
But why are you authorizing them to wear a police uniform?
Just to... Okay, sir. Sir.
Okay,
ladies and gentlemen.
Listen. Okay, go ahead.
Section 10, Rules of Court, Rule 113. Ang Section 11 nito, yung palaging alam na natin na palaging inuulit-ulit na Attorney Torreon. Right of the officer to break into building or enclosure. Back one up, Section 10. Officer may summon assistance. An officer making a lawful arrest may orally summon as many persons as he deems necessary to assist him in effecting the arrest. Every person so summoned by an officer shall assist him in effecting the arrest when he can render such assistance without detriment to himself. Allowed by rule, sir. Why are they using the uniform? At that time, I gave them the authorization. That's an exemption in Rule 179, Section 179 of the Revised Penal Code, because that is to ease their entry para matapos na lang, sir. Kasi mga-aresto naman kami, sir. Mga-aresto, rather than arrest these people from KOGC, preventing the entry of people that we legally summon to assist us in effecting this arrest of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy. Pinag-uniform na lang namin, sir, para sila ay makapasok nang hindi na pinipigilan.
So you summon the services of these civilians?
Yes, sir.
To effect the arrest of Pastor Quiboloy?
Yes,
or
sir.
Or to dig a tunnel below the
to
building?
To dig a tunnel, because it is the way for us to break into the tunnel that we suspect Apollo Quiboloy is hiding, sir. That's also in relation to Section 11, which gives the peace officer the right to break into any building or enclosure to effect the arrest, sir.
Don't you think that you have abused this particular provision of the rules of court na overstretching? Kasi, tingnan mo, Link of time, 13 days. Where in the world have you effect as warrant of arrest for 13 days staying in a particular place?
Sir, I will cover that in our presentation. After a territorial narrative.
Sir,
thank you.
If I may, sir.
Babalikan kita niya mamaya pag-present mo. I will ask the same question.
Yes, sir.
And I will further... ask further question.
Yes, sir.
Sir, you, sir. Well, just a little repartee to the, since he is citing a law, I hope the good general would be enlightened that he can invoke that provision when he is making a lawful arrest. In this case, 13 days have already elapsed. There is no lawful arrest yet. When an officer, sir, kanang yung provision na gisite niya, aresto, meron yung akusado, siya lang isa. Pare, tulungan mo ako kasi i-arresto natin siya. Maski civilian pwede. Kung ginagawa nila, hindi ito applicable yung kanilang proviso. Kasi mga civilian ito, dinadamitan nila, minor pa, tapos hindi para pag-aresto, ang dami na nila. Do they need 5,000 personnel plus civilians just to arrest a one person? That's a misreading of the law, overstretching of the law, and that is, I don't know, that requires further seminar in a law school, probably, Your Honor.
Ako, I am not a lawyer. Pero, I can hardly believe that you are going to summon the services of this civilian not to arrest Pastor Kibuloy, but to look for Pastor Kibuloy. As you said, na ginagamit ninyo yan sa pagtataniling doon, sa paghuhukay, therefore, you are not effecting an arrest. You are looking, you are searching for Pastor Kibuloy. Pag nahirapan kang mag-aresto ng tao, you can summon the services of other people. Tulungan nyo ako dito, I am a police officer. Hulihin po itong tao, malaki ito masyado. Tulungan nyo ako, makasummon ka ng services ng ibang tao. Pag-aresto, but not to look for Pastor Kibuloy as stated in that rules of court.
Si Chair.
General Turi, you respond. Pareho tayong police, pareho tayong hindi abogado.
Sir, that will be covered in the presentation, sir. We assure you okay. That it will be covered.
Sige, later.
Chair, may I just point out something? That even though it has gone through ridiculous lengths, you look at the face of General Torre, and what you will see is the face of someone who doesn't care. His interpretation right now is the only thing that matters. Siya ang batas. And that was how we have experienced him all these days. Yung kapricho, yung whims, yung very tyrannical, ako ang batas. Kahit nakaharap mo na yung mga senador, nagbe-behave ka lang dyan, no? But in reality...
Please address your statement
Chair.
To the chairman.
Mr. Chair.
Huwag mong direkta sa kanya.
Yes, Mr. Chair. Yes. Sorry. Yes. So ganun lang yan, Mr. That's all I want to say, really. That it's very... even though it has gone through ridiculous lengths, no? For him, if he what he believes and what we've experienced, no? Is that his interpretation is the one that matters and it will be the one that will get followed. Wala nang rule of law. Lahat iikutin through ridiculous lengths.
Your observation is very valid and I am taking note of that. Thank you. I would like to ask Yusik Lord Villanueva about your interpretation. Lahat tayo dito nag-interpret nitong rules of court. Yung sinabi ni General Torre, ayaw ko nang tanungin si General Attorney Torreon dahil he is from the opposing party. I presume you are neutral. Pwede ko bang using that particular provision of the rules of court, pwede ko bang isumon yung mga civilian para hanapin si Pastor Kibuloy magdidig ng tunnel doon? Can I do that?
Your Honor, the standard established by the rules of court is reasonableness. So in this case, if the PNP has reasonable ground to believe that indeed the pastor is hiding underground and through their instruments and through their machines, they have reasonable ground to believe that he is indeed underground, then the rules of court allow the peace officer, the police officer, to break in to an enclosure. So by that interpretation, sir, breaking in would include perhaps tunneling or digging to reach the enclosure where it is reasonably believed.
I am not asking you about the reasonableness. I am asking you about summoning the services of this civilian in order to arrest Pastor Kibuloy. The act is not actually making the arrest. The act is searching for Pastor Kibuloy. So can I ask these people to help me dig a tunnel to look for Pastor Kibuloy, then eventually arrest him?
Your Honor, the provision does not place a limitation as to the time when this summoning of assistance would be given. So I would respectfully disagree with the contention that this must be done at the very moment that the person to be arrested is cited. It could be done in the process of breaking into the enclosure where the person to be arrested is believed to be found. That is the my respectful opinion, Your Honor.
Thank you. Thank you. Human rights. You're a lawyer, ma'am? RD, human rights?
Yes po, Your Honor. But
can you share us? Can you share with us your thoughts on this?
Judging from the arguments from both parties, pero medyo nalito na rin po ako because I'm no longer a legal expert as to this matter. But may I, the president of the Integrated Bar of the Philippines here in Davao City, may I pass the ball to her?
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Please, President of the IBP, Davao City, Attorney Aiza Kanda. You have the floor, ma'am.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. I have a different opinion with regard to Section 10 of Rule 113. My understanding with respect to this article is that the officer is actually in the act of making the arrest. And he may call, of course, as many assistants as he can, but with what's happening now with KOJC, there are thousands of them inside the premises. So what's the point of asking a civilian to assess or to assist in the arrest? So in the actual of making a lawful arrest, they are still searching. They are still searching in the vicinity. So they are asking for help.
That is why I am trying to make a distinction between the act of arresting and the act of searching.
Yes.
That's why I want to establish the difference between the two.
Yes.
So yun nga. So
my opinion is that
your opinion,
he can ask for assistance in the act of actually doing the actual arrest and not in the search of or effecting the search of the arrest or the search of the person to be arrested.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Ito, magaling ito na abogado. Ito, yakong nirespeto ko yung opinion nito. Commissioner Alberto Bernardo, sir, please share with us your thoughts on this. In relation to the police operational procedures that we are observing in the PNP and the NAPULCOM, please continue.
Marami po salamat pa, mayroong tagapangulo. Yung arrest po kasi is a continuing act. Kung yung tao po polite, tumatakas, yung pagtugon sa kautusan ng arrest warrant is a continuing act also. Kaya kung naniniwala po ang kapulisan na nandoon sa ilalim, merong bunker doon, continuing act po yun. Kaya makukonsider natin na yung ginagawa ng police is furtherance of the arrest. Kaya kung gagamit po ng gadget ng LMD, yun po ang magtutukoy para gumawa ng paghuhukay at pagtukoy doon sa tao. Kaya sa tingin ko po, with all due respect doon sa colleague, continuing act po kasi, kaya hindi po static yun. Na tapos yung arrest pag nakita mo yung tao. Kaya kung yung gadget po naniniwala sila nasa kabilang kwarto, ginamit po natin ito sa Marawi. Alam natin nasa kwarto siya. Yung terrorism, continuing acting yun. Ganoon din po rito, kung nagtatago yung tao sa ilalim, continuing act, kaya kasama po yun sa pagtugon doon sa service of warrant.
Alam mo, if we are going to continue with that continuing act, the occupation of the PNP on the KOJC will continue on and on and on and on. Do you agree with me? Until they define the physical body of Pastor Kibuloy. Do you agree with me?
Yung naulat po kanina, kung wala na pong hudyat, kaya ng ginawa po natin doon sa Baguio, nung gumuho yung isang hotel doon, kung merong hudyat na merong pang marerescue rito sa ilalim, dapat patuloy po rin yun. Ganun din po sa pag-aresto. Kung sakaling wala nang madetekto na taong merong buhay sa ilalim doon, eh dapat itigil na rin yun. Kaya magiging basehan po natin yung ginagamit nila doon sa rescue equipment ng DNR, ng MMDA, at ng Bureau of Fire Protection. Sila po ang magsasabi, yun po yung reasonableness po.
Ako, bilang isang dating pulis, nakikita ko yung reasonableness na nasabi natin ay talagang masyadong subjective. Kung ako, gusto kong i-occupy yung QJC forever, forever ko rin sasabihin na may heartbeat ako na didetect. So, hanggang saan ito ngayon? Ako, forever ko talaga, gusto kong i-occupy yan eh. The mere fact, nagdala ako ng 3,000 na police dyan, may intention talaga akong i-occupy yan, yung buong grounds na yan. So sabihin ko forever, heartbeat dito ngayon, hinukay, wala. Uy, may heartbeat naman ako na-detect noon. Who will police the police pagdating sa bagay na yan?
Yun po ay pwede nang iakyat sa husgado. Kung sa tingin po ng husgado ay hindi na to reasonable, inilift po yung execution ng warrant of arrest. Magbibigay po ng mga kondisyon yung husgado na hindi na rin tama yun. Ito po, hindi po kasi judgment call yung magiging basihan po ng continuation ng execution ng warrant.
No, pwedeng judgment call yan. Hindi, sabihin ng police na it's my judgment na nandyan po si Pastor Cribuloy. Who will be against me? Nga nga po ako, sabi ko, nandyan pa rin yan. Sigurado ako. Walang katapusan. Thank you, Attorney. Thank you. Attorney from DOJ, City Prosecutor, Attorney Sanyel. Attorney Sanyel, can we hear from you? That's why we invited you because we need your opinion, sir. Please.
Magandang hapon po sa lahat, sir. Mr. Chair. Hindi po ako authorized magbigay ng opinion on that matter. Can I be allowed to defer on that comment, sir?
Mukhang tuwang-tuwa kayo dyan. Pumalakpak kayo. Ha? Ano pala siya? Prosecutor ka?
Yes, sir.
What's the difference between the prosecutors and other people from DOJ who are giving their opinion in our previous hearings?
Sir, in my capacity, sir, is about the trafficking case that was...
Trafficking?
Yes, sir, yung number 3 item, sir.
I thought being a prosecutor, you are prohibited from giving your legal opinion on this matter?
Yes, correct? Sir, in my capacity.
In your capacity as a prosecutor?
I cannot give my opinion, sir, on this matter, sir.
So itong ibang taga DOJ sa Senado na nagbibigay ng opinion, they are not prosecutors?
They are part of the DOJ, sir, but they are authorized to give their opinion, sir.
Thank you.
Salamat, sir.
Sino pang abogado dyan na pwede magbigay
ng opinion? Your Honor. Malapit na po, mag-aral pa ako next time.
Sige.
Your Honor,
pakinggan natin.
Opo, hindi po ako abogado pero common sense po, Your Honor. Huwag natin paikot-ikutin po mga with due respect, NAPOLCOM, DOJ, DILG, the generals here and the colonels po.
Please do not direct your comments.
Yes po. Sorry po, Your Honor.
Oh, kasi ako'y nakiusap sa kanila na mag-share ng kanilang opinion tapos bigla mo silang personalin sila isa-isa.
Apo,
that would be against the ethics of this committee.
Sorry po, Your Honor. It's my mistake po.
Thank you. Right.
Tumatanggap naman po kami ng mali pag nagkamali po kami.
Okay.
Salamat po, Your Honor. I think it's an insult to the 3,000 strong men of PNP with the elite forces, special action force. Tapos tutugisin mo isang individual lang. Mag-hire ka pa ng hindi police, damitan mo po ng police. Your Honor, papayag ko po ba? Yung uniform niyo po is papasusot sa hindi po police. Wala pong limit. For example, pwede ko pong sabihin, ako si General Torre, I can hire 1,000 civilians. Pasok kayo dito sa compound. I-search natin.
Ganito kasi yan. I'm not, hindi I'm not reading their minds, no? Pero sa, siguro sa expertise, you have 3,000 policemen na hindi mga minero, hindi marunong maghukay, hindi maghanap, marunong maghanap ng bina. Ito siguro, hinire nila yung mga tao na yun because talaga magaling yun sa paghukay. Ang gusto nating masettle nito ngayon, yung paggamit sa kanila sa paghukay at paghahanap doon sa kay Pastor Kibuloy ay yung nga, kaya nga tinatanong natin yung mga legal opinions ng ating mga lawyers dito, yun ba justified? Justified ba? As far as the use of uniform, police uniform, inamin naman ni Gerald Torre that he authorizes the use of the uniform. He authorized the use of uniform for easy access papasok doon sa loob ng kingdom.
Your Honor, kunwari may mga NPA criminal pwedeng gamitin po yan papasok sa loob. Paano po namin matcheck po, Your Honor? Anybody can do that. Wala po kasi naka-uniform na eh.
Oh, pero NPA naman yon, mag-aaway ba itong kawakaaway ba itong polis at saka
mga
NPA?
Mga eskalawag at preso po, pwede pong damitan po yan, papasukin po sa loob, Your Honor. Ano pong control po dyan? Eh, authorized pala eh.
Kaya nga natin ngayon tinatakil yan dahil nga dito tayo ngayon sa arrest at saka sa search eh, paggamit ng tao. Ako, as I am concerned, I am not a lawyer, pero ginamit nila yung tao para mag-search. Maghanap kay Pastor Kibuloy. Hindi para mag-aristo kay Pastor Kibuloy. On the contrary, the opinion of our lawyers, sir, na Pulcom and other lawyers, nagsasabi na continuing the yung act of arresting Pastor Kibuloy. Matagal na debate ito. Anyway, hindi ka pa man tapos. Narinig ko na yung side mo, pero continue ka sa presentation mo.
Sir?
We will leave that matter at pag-usapan natin mamaya. Attorney, hindi na kabugado pa.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Just with respect to the fact that Section 11 is very clear when they are making an arrest. Unfortunately, there is no arrest yet here. And then they used Insignia. Sir, I just want to point out, sir, that the allowing persons who are not police to use police insignia is a violation of Article 179 of the Revised Penal Code. Plus, a second thing, sir, is the fact that they use a child, a minor, to use that. That is, again, child abuse. I just want to point out that to the
court. Yeah, thank you. General Turi, bakit ba kayo gumamit ng minor? Kung digging ang purpose nyo doon, mag-hukay, bakit babae ba yan? Parang babae yung... Lalaki ba yun? Minor? Bakit kayo gumamit ng minor?
Your Honor, I do believe at this point in time na wala namang nag-establish na minor. Those are all allegations. And I can categorically say na walang minor dun, sir. Baka mukhang bata lang.
Mukhang bata, pero...
Mukhang bata lang, but really...
For the record.
For the record, sir, none.
For the record, pinasok mo yun it's for the purpose of digging or
yes,
for
sir.
The purpose of... Baka mamaya ang apprehension nila is... Gagamitin na naman ninyo doon sa loob na parang victim of trafficking, sir, na naman.
Of course not, sir.
The purpose... Yung apprehension nila, ha? Pero for the record,
the instruments indicate that our targets could be 4 meters below ground. And I believe that we need experts on this matter, especially on digging this hole, because we want to ensure that these people have the experience. That's something that the police does every day. So who are the people who knows and has the experience on digging? Minero, sir.
So with that explanation of yours, it is the impression of this committee that you admit that you really did a digging below the GMC.
Yes, sir. It's part of our presentation later on, sir. And just a presentation, sir.
Kaya in-admit mo.
Yes, sir.
Kala ko hindi mo i-admit. I am ready to set you in contempt kung hindi
mo i-admit.
Ako mismo, you have no way to lie before me because ako mismo, pinuntahan ko kanina sa inspection kanina, hinukay namin doon, very fresh pa yung simento na ginawa at nung natanggal yung simento, yung mga kabilya na nilagay doon, hindi kabilya na construction na related ba kabilya, kundi kung saan-saan lang napulot na kabilya yon, And yung lupa is very loose. But then that's immaterial anymore to discuss about that because you admit that you did the digging below that the basement of GMC building.
Yes, sir. I have I have lots of bosses who are class 87 okay. And they can testify on the kind of destruction that Feast of Cadet First Class Bato de la Rosa, sir, can come to them if they violate the rules, sir. So I really will not dare to do that and lie to you.
Yeah, thank be you, sure, sir. Just be sure because, you know, it pains me to cite you in contempt if I need to do that because you are the regional director of this particular police regional office of this region. And that would be a slap on the PNP kapag ang kanilang boss ay na-cite in contempt ng isang committee hearing because of lying and testifying falsely before the committee.
Yes, sir.
I hate to do that.
Yes, sir.
Please make sure that you don't lie to this committee.
It will be part of the presentation, sir. And even the future diggings is included there, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Meron pa yung future digging?
Mr. Chair.
It's included in the presentation, sir.
Mr. Chair.
Andali, ha? Unahin ko muna si Jason San. Nauna nag-kwan.
Salamat po.
Yeah.
I just want to know from the chair whether the digging was in accordance with the law. I'd like to ask, therefore, the chair to ask the PNP whether they secured a digging permit because the structural integrity of the building, which carried preschool, kindergarten, elementary students, high school students, college students, postgraduate, nangangani po ang buhay nila. Doon sa integrity ng gusali, kung ito ay magkakaroon ng konting pag-inog ng mundo, huwag sabihin siya pa, huwag muli inog taon, asa man po nito ng mga batang gagmay, nga huwag magiging sila ibang kaagan, anang maong pangitabo. Where did they secure a permit from the building official of the city, Mr. Chair?
General Torre.
Sir,
the question is, did you secure a digging permit from the building officials of the city of Davao or any permit from DNR for that matter? Before no, you do that?
No, sir.
No?
No, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
Mr. Thank Chair. You for that answer.
Mr. Chair, may I
So help? It's noted by this committee that he did not secure any permit
Mr.
from
Chair.
Any pertinent and competent government agency that is regulating the digging operations.
Mr. Chair.
Go ahead, Attorney Fuentes.
Thank you, sir. Sir, considering that he hired civilians, may we know the names of the civilians that he hired for the digging, sir?
So, you should understand that their property was negatively impacted by the digging operations. That's why they are looking for the names of those people responsible in the digging. So, since ikaw ang nag-recruit noon, please give us the name. Submit to this committee.
Mr. Chair? Okay? Yes, Mr. Chair, we will...
Ilan yon?
I have lost track, maybe around 7 or 6.
7.
Mr. Chair. But we will provide it to you and just consult my...
Please, before this hearing ends, please submit to this committee.
But I would like to state for the record, Your Honor, that everything that they did is under my responsibility. I take full responsibility for their actions.
You are the commander. You should assume all responsibility.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Assume all the responsibility. You are the commander.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes. Building official of Davao City.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Kas tung yali. Right.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. May I ask General Torre if during the time of excavation and all of the construction activities done in the basement, was there a professional engineer architect supervising over the work being done
Thank you. You heard the question. Please answer.
Yes, sir. We have structural engineers and...
Sino? Regional engineering service mo?
We have one civil, one architect, and one structural engineer, sir. I'll cover everything in the presentation, sir.
Ano doon sa presentation mo?
Sir.
Meron silang engineer.
That question came about because earlier when General Torre was talking, he said they hired the experts for digging, which were yung mga minero. In my opinion, that's hindi siguro tama. Yung eksperto natin doon is yung minero. If yung safety, yung like it was mentioned earlier in the rules of court, yung breaking in, Your Honor, humingi kasi ako ng opinion from NBCDO, National Building Code Development Office, yung executive officer nila. I ask if yung breaking in doon is applicable to the breaking of building or demolition of any part thereof. According to the commissioner, ang sabi niya sa akin is yung breaking in can apply to breaking of a door or a window to access a building. However, yung act of demolition or breaking structural parts of a building is a regulated activity and it should need a permit or order from the court na will order perhaps the building official to give assistance to whoever is undertaking the job. That's all, Mr. Chair. Thank
noted,
you.
Noted. Sino yun? Sino yung tinanong mo?
Si Attorney Belderol, sir.
Sino
Attorney.
Siya?
National Building Code Development Office. I think he is the executive director or okay. Currently, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Well noted.
Mr. Chair, in connection with this, considering that I am the chairman of the board of the Jose Maria College Foundation Incorporated, if ever there is going to be any structural damage to the building of JMC, is the police willing to pay for the damages due to the digging that they caused?
I presume they have to pay kung mayroong court order ordering them to pay whatever damages that they have done. Am I correct, General Torre?
Yes, sir. Definitely, sir.
Mr. Chair.
So, bayaran nila. Kung you file the corresponding case and the decision na ng korte, bayaran natin sa PNP.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Go ahead.
A few days ago, General Torre was in a press con and he very clearly stated that there was no digging. He denied that he nag-dig ang PNP and he said that excavation didn't exist and he also said that those were just Photoshop pictures.
Okay. But that statement was not given before this committee.
Yes.
Before you.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Before the public. Before the public.
He said it in a press con. So, Mr. Chair, this again is the problem that he maybe can tell the truth to you. But once you leave.
For fear of yes. Becoming.
Yes.
Being cited in contempt.
Yes.
Because I am serious in my job. I don't care kung sino man. Basta if you testify falsely before this committee, I have to cite you in contempt.
Yes, Mr. Chair, but unfortunately, not all of us are senators. And the Filipino people are not senators. And he blatantly lied to the Filipino people about it.
Will you please respond, General Torre? Why did you lie before the Filipino people that... You did not do such digging.
Sir, masyado tayo nasa sidetrack. Hindi ko maintindihan, sir, ang sinasabi ni Dr. Badoy.
Kung
simple. Kailang ginawa, sir, I did not do that.
Napakasimple lang.
I did not do that, sir.
Hindi ka?
I did not do that and I did not say that.
If you can present
to me the video, maybe I can review it. But right now, there's no video presented except for the statement of Dr. Badoy who is delaying the presentation of Attorney Torreon.
Okay. Can you please give me that video?
Yeah, the press con 2 days ago, he even challenged Attorney Torreon to prove it.
Ang sabi kasi niya sa press con, he has to, that's the allegation of Attorney Torreon, and he should prove it in court, and he should prove it, walang in court, he should prove it because nasa Photoshop naman yan. Parang Photoshop na yan. Oh, yun po, sabi niya.
Sige, last response before we proceed. Para,
Sometimes I'm really thinking that they don't want to proceed with their presentation. But I think that sidetracks the issue. Because as to the moment, sir, Dr. Badoy is making an allegation, sir.
This committee does not believe that it hijacks the issue.
Okay,
that,
sir.
That issue is very important and very relevant in this investigation.
So the answer, sir, is no. I did not say things that that Dr. Badoy is attributing to me.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Later on, Dr. Badoy, you...
We're retrieving the press con, Mr. Chair, where he blatantly and clearly stated that there was no excavation and that those were just Photoshop photos.
Okay. Noted. Kung meron kayong recordings, palabas natin. Please continue.
One last question regarding sa excavation. Bakit po minadali nila tinabunan kaagad para hindi po nyo makita ng committee po ninyo? Madali po yun, sir. Overnight po, sir. Napakabilis po natabunan kaagad. Kung sabi niya, accountable siya doon sa paghuhukay.
Okay. Let's be frank about it. Bakit niyo tinabunan kaagad?
Sir, that will be covered my presentation, sir. Even before, without even the silent hearing, we will cover it, sir.
We'll wait for your presentation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Continue.
So after that, Your Honor, though we have strong reservations to the legal opinion of our respected government officers, Your Honor, and I am really concerned with the legal opinions that they expressed, no, knowing that they represent the Department of Justice. But anyway, we will continue, Your Honor. At 9 p.m. again, Your Honor, we already covered that. This is on August 29. Unidentified men again were entering, and some had very long haircuts, no? And one was with Bird and escorted by the PNP to the compound. But that's covered already. So let's go to August 30, Honor, at 9 a.m., no? The police, through PRO 11 Logistics Office, once again attempted to cart away. They wanted to get the KOJC fire truck, no? Good that lawyer was present there and they would have been able to seize the fire truck, Your Honor. And the respondents here placed their own battery in order to sneak away the fire truck. Yeah. And at 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. on August 30, there were two PNP choppers. And General Torre was clearly on board because he was shown, Your Honor, some cameras had strong power to capture who, even if they are meters away. And I think General Torre admitted that he was on board the chopper, no? But the problem is that it hovered too low, and we had reasons to believe that it was purposive, Your Honor, because of the solar panel installed at the top of the building. We had reasons to believe that they were thinking that the solar panels were supplying electricity to the imaginary bunker that they have made the public believe is existing, but despite 14 days, they have not been able to locate. What actually transpired is that our solar panels, Your Honor.
Excuse me. General Torre, did you intentionally instruct the pilot of the chopper to go low so that in order to destroy that solar panels?
No, sir. For that, sir, we deeply apologize, and we are willing to pay the KOJC regarding the solar panel if we really cause that the destruction of that panel.
Thank you.
Because that will be a very dangerous maneuver, yeah, for us. Because
kayo ang pasahero diyan, delikado pag,
yes, sir.
Pag lumipad yung solar panel, tumama doon sa helicopter ninyo.
Of course, sir.
Sabog kayo.
Yes, sir. Obviously.
Please continue.
So the word of General Torre would bind the PNP that they will pay, Your Honor.
Yes, they will pay.
Thank you, Your Honor. So proceeding from that, Your Honor, this also, Your Honor, is very concerning because one alleged policeman, Your Honor, was dressed as a policeman using police uniform, but it turned out to be a former member of the KOJC who testified during the Senate investigation, Your Honor. And his name is Edward Masayon, but he was made to wear as if his last name was Esclito. And this is really concerning, Your Honor, because the police is allowing certain members, former members, disgruntled members who testified even against the accused as one of their alleged policemen. May we ask General Torre about this, Your Honor?
You answer the question.
What is their issue, sir?
Ang former member ng KOJC na pinasuot niyo ng uniforme at pinapasok doon sa loob.
Are they admitting, sir, that Edward Masayon is a former member of the KOJC?
Ha? Huh?
Are they admitting that Edward Masayon is a former member of the KOJC?
It's written there, sir.
Oh, yeah.
So
did they admit
that bolsters our allegation that we have credible informants regarding the presence of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy?
So meaning yang si Masayon ang source of information mo?
One of the many.
One. Kailan niyo tiniwalag ito from QJC? Kailan ito?
Your Honor, because of course, if we want to get information from, we want to get information as to the whereabouts of Pastor Quiboloy, we cannot get it from our other resource persons from the other end of the table because they're all believers of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy.
Okay.
I think you get the drift, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Kailan niyo ito tiniwalag sa church niyo?
Matagal na, sir. Kasi
how many years?
I'm not sure. I'll check. We'll check with our HRMD kasi lahat naman po nung umaalis sa Kingdom of Jesus Christ, meron po yung process at meron pong memo. So, before this matatapos to, ang tanong, yung mga tinatawag nila na witnesses nila at mga nag-i-intel kung nandun talaga si Pastor Quiboloy, tama ba, sir? Tatanong ko lang po, Mr. Chair, kung dadamitan nila ng police, at hindi pa napapatunayan kung sino.
Well, since General Torre admits that pinasuot nila ng uniform, did you admit na pinasuot nila ng uniform yan? Okay. Inadmit nila yan na pinasuot nila ng uniform para makapasok doon sa loob. Then, nasa inyo na yan. Pwede nyo kasuhan yung nagsuot ng uniform at saka yung nagpapasuot ng uniform because he is not a policeman. So, we have prevailing laws prohibiting such act. So, bahala na kayo.
Okay.
Inadmit naman niya in open hearing na siyang nag-authorize. Okay.
Thank you po.
Please continue.
2016 po siya.
2016. Ah, po. So, 8 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So, do you think yung kanyang information ay still updated and reliable?
Sir, actually, ganito yon. Yung mga ginamit nila na siguro mga intel nila or asset, kasi minamask nila talaga. Tapos, siyempre, pinapapasok. Although alam namin, yan, mga dissidents yan yung mga false witnesses nila. Tapos pinapapasok nila. Noong, kukwento ko lang sir saglit, nagsisearch na sila sa quarters namin, particularly my room. Hindi lang 20 times sila bumalik. Kaya nga, as now, hindi ako mababalik sa room. Mayroon siyang kausap, ma'am, nandito kami sa loob, meaning to say may nagdidiktar. Yun nga lang, yung mga umalis na, yung mga dissidents, yung mga false witnesses nila, matagal nang wala doon. Dumaan na yung COVID, dumaan na lahat ng kung ano-ano pa mga changes namin sa mga rooms namin, hindi na nila kabisado. Kaya si General Torre litong-lito, pang ilang beses siyang bumalik, particularly my room, admittedly, because may lagusan talaga yun. May lagusan papunta sa main quarters dati, sa quarters ni Pastor, yung room ko. And they have violated it at I don't know how many times anymore. May nagdidikta. pabalik-balik, may nagdidikta, hindi nila alam, nag-iiba. Siyempre, may mga changes tayo sa mga, may mga renovations kami. So yung mga intel nila, yung mga asset nila, yung mga dati na obsolete na, sir. Kaya ngayon, ang dami nila hinahanap. Mali-mali na, sir, eh. Yun doon.
Talagang, this committee believes na yung kalang informant ay palpak.
As kahit in failure.
Hindi nila nakuha si Pastor Kipuloy.
Opo, mission failure.
Mali yung information na ibinigay.
Sa ilang libo na po sila. Doon na. Tapos, dapat isang araw mahanap na nila. Tapos, 13 days na. Doon na sila nakatira lahat. Yun lang naman ang ano namin dito po sa committee. Okay, maraming salamat, sir.
Please continue, Attorney Torrio, kasi okay, meron silang pre-prepare din. Pakikita
okay
natin sila.
We're now on August 30, Honor, I believe. August 29 pa ba tayo, Iha? Ayan, we're finished with that. And then, day 7, Your Honor. At 2:30 at August 30. This time, Your Honor, again, this proves that they are really on a fishing expedition. And the reasonable belief theory would really be questionable, Your Honor, because at 2:30 p.m., again, they attempted to enter KOJC property in the Prayer Mountain located at Barangay Tamayong Kalinan, Davao City without any document being presented. And they even attempted to enter the said premises because one of the policemen said that they were searching for Pastor Apollo Sikibuloy. And that proves, Your Honor, that the arrest warrant here has been used as an excuse to provide some legal color to their illegal activities because this property, Your Honor, is located more than 50 kilometers away from the KOJC compound. Next slide, please. Mm-hmm. And then at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, SWAT team, Your Honor, strongly insisted to be allowed entry into the compound. And accordingly, they were there to allegedly help and take control of egress and ingress, including they attempted to take control of the scanner of Gate 18, Your Honor. It was an attempted expropriation. Luckily, the lawyers and members of the KOJC insisted that there is no proper basis for sequestration or even expropriation, Your Honor. But they continued to sit in the area for a long time, Your Honor, despite the fact that the proper usage of the SWAT team in cases of under the PNP Memorandum Circulars, Your Honor, is not present. So tensions grew because the number of SWAT forces increased. And but in fairness also to the SWAT team, they did not insist also, they did not really take over the, what you call this, scanning machine, but they just attempted to do that. And then the KOJC Cathedral continued to be under their control. And despite requests from the lawyers to go inside, they were denied. Next slide, please. Day 8, Your Honor. And here, the talk of the members is that they were already engaged in treasure hunting because as you can see, the persons inside are no longer policemen really, but abanteros, Your Honor, civilians. And they turned our school as their boarding houses because the pictures were taken that they were taking a bath at the building, people wearing shorts and t-shirts, and they were sleeping on the on the hallway and literally almost everywhere in the compound, Your Honor. And at 9 to 10 a.m. on August 31, while the police seemed to convince the public and their superiors that they have positively found the bunker, there was a talk that they already found the bunker, no? But again, they seemed to send the wrong idea because the proton helic was used even in the garden, Your Honor, of KOJC, several meters away from the JMC compound. And then at 9:30 a.m., Your Honor, that is our school, Your Honor, and they are sleeping in the hallway because of their sheer number. Some are using the classrooms, And a teacher, while cleaning, found a bullet at the GMCFI building, Your Honor, second floor. Then next slide, please. And actually here, we have reasons to believe that they were using really the arrest warrant as some form of a legal excuse to justify their perpetuation of stay in the KOJC compound. And if you note, Your Honor, they attempted to enter a minor, and if you notice also on TV, they introduced alleged victims of human trafficking, the two victims, Your Honor. But it turned out to be a dud because one of the alleged victim, the woman, no, turned out to be a member of the KOJC for 10 years. And the daughter was only concerned of her safety. And when she tried to enter the compound asking for clearance, she was prevented, prevent po. Pero nung narinig na medyo concerned siya sa kanyang mama, ni-refer po sa kanilang mga higher ups. At yun ang naging istorya, victims po ng human trafficking. No? At yun ang na-news. It painted a very bad background against us and against the KOJC. But it turned out that the information was not true. And these individuals already executed affidavits that they were not victims of human trafficking. No? And then there was also talk on this day that mayroon namang ipasok na sex slave daw, sex slave of Pastor Kibuloy. Dito yung lumabas yung mga fake news na may hidden room, may mga secret chamber, sex layers, news which were aired without getting the side of KOJC members. And we already wrote letters to these media outfits and requested them to take down these news items which did not follow journalistic ethics. Next slide, please. And then in the morning, they even attempted, Your Honor, clearly offending religious feelings, because all KOJC members already know that Pastor Apollo C. Kibuloy has a warrant of arrest. Yet they printed a tarpaulin and even posted it at the gate 18 of the compound. Luckily, Attorney Adam Jambangan intercepted the same and had it removed. No, and they also tried to set up a tent within the property of the KOJC, but because of the objections of the petitioners, no, the officers decided not to continue with it. No, and then they again, police K-9 units arrived at the compound on this day, and on September 1. This was the 39th anniversary of the Feast of the Passover. Actually, the day before this, Your Honor, I responded to the text message of General Torre to probably if we can talk. So I responded, yes, we can talk. And we went to a hotel, Your Honor, and I was accompanied by the head executive of KOJC. The purpose of which, actually, Your Honor, is to request him to use at least for one day the cathedral so that they can exercise their religious rights and celebrate properly the 39th anniversary of the Feast of the Passover, which is actually one of the main celebrations being conducted by the KOJC every year. Now, he referred me to, he told me, discuss that with Colonel Marantan. And we discussed the matter with Colonel Marantan. And we were given three choices, Your Honor. One in the cathedral, and one facing the cathedral, and another one fronting the kingdom. And Colonel Marantan was honest enough to tell us that it's beyond him. He will consult his superiors. But his superiors, Your Honor, denied our request to use the cathedral. And we were made to use the KOJC compound. Area, cemented area fronting the kingdom. And as you know, the vagaries of nature would prevent us to use it during the morning and lunchtime and in the early afternoon because of too much heat. So the main program started late in the afternoon at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, Your Honor.
Mr. Chair.
Go ahead.
The video of the press con of General Torre where he denies that there is an excavation is ready right now. And I'm also holding a PhilStar, a GMA News Online article. Ang title po, Hole Dug at KOJC Compound, the Cops Deny Allegation. This is September 4. And ang sabi dito, sir, the alleged digging has reportedly reached 8 meters and the PRO 11 was quick to deny the allegation. Quote, yan sa digging na yan, allegation ni Attorney Torion yan. Let him prove it. PRO 11 Director Brigadier General Nicolas Torres said. So he's lying blatantly here in Senate, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, maybe play the video.
Yeah, go ahead. Please play the video. Pwede yung lakasan yung volume. Hanggang ngayon, meron pa yung mga... Maklaro. Hindi nyo kaya?
Tama. Sandali lang, sir.
Mr. Chair. Yung the copy of the link of the GMA News Online where he is caught lying to you, I will send it.
Okay. Please.
Very clearly lying, Mr. Chair.
Correct. Kung sinabi niya, hindi totoo yung digging niya. Sa hearing natin, inamin niya, he was lying doon sa yung press ko na yan. And with that, tanungin natin bakit nagbago yung stand niya. Bakit noon, dinay niya at ngayon inaamin niya na existing talaga yung ginawa nilang digging.
Mr. Chair.
Can you respond?
Sir, I'm still looking for the video. Sabi, hindi nila ma-play nga sir. Andiyan na sir, oh. Let's wait for
Sandali lang. Ang nakili kasi. Hindi mo na marinig. Sige lang, you reserve your answer after marinig natin to Claro.
Yes, sir.
Huh? You can sit down.
I really wonder, sir, if Attorney Torino would really like to continue because parang nasa side talk tayo, sir.
As I have said, this is my committee. I decide what to listen and what not to listen. Okay? Importante yan eh. Sige lang. Kaya na ninyo para maklaro natin.
Mr. Chair.
Yes.
Just a short manifestation while they are preparing for the video.
Okay.
Ilang araw na po simula nung sila'y pumasok ng ika-24 ng buwan ng Agosto. ang buong property po ng Kingdom of Jesus Christ ay mga 30 hektarya or 300,000 square meters. Kung doon na lang ho sa conservative estimate na 3,000 yung pulis na po ginamit para hanapin at arestuhin si Mr. Kibuloy, that would be 100 square meter bawat isang pulis. Mas malaki pa ho yung 100 square meter dito sa kwartong ito. Common sense will tell us.
Sorry, 23 hectares
lang pala. I'm corrected, Mr. Chair. But even assuming arguendo that it's 30 hectares or 300,000 square meter divided by 3,000 policemen, that would only be 100 square meter. Yung pong 100 square meter, Mr. Chairman, kahit isang oras lang ho, mahalugpug na natin yung kaliit-liitang bahagi ng kwartong ito. So, kung ilang araw na pong lumipas at hindi pa rin nila nakita, kung ganun sila karami, ewan ko, ako po'y hindi dalubasa sa mathematics, bagamat ang lahat ng grado ko po ay 98 sa math.
Dali lang. Ilang story, ilang floors yung highest building ng QGC? Ilang floors?
Minister Katiil, ilang palapag daw yung pinakamatanggap?
5.
4 floors.
5.
5 including the rooftop, sir.
Including the rooftop.
Sa 23... Sige po.
Yung 30 mo kanina.
Opo.
Granting na yung buong 30 hectares is covered with 5 floors. So i-multiply mo.
Hindi po, sir. Kasi kinorek na po ako. 23 hectares lang daw.
23?
Oo.
But still, it took them 13 days.
Kaya nga po, pagpalagyan na natin, sir, Mr. Chairman, na 200 square meter bawat isang pulis, siguro naman sa isang araw, sir, kaya na nating libutin yon. Ano po?
Correct.
Yun lamang pong manifestation ko, sir.
Yeah. But again, we will receive their answer that they have reasonable ground to believe that Pastor Kibuloy is still there underneath the surface because of that heartbeat na ini-insist nila. So ngayon, after ng presentation nyo, after presentation nila, we will delve on that issue.